Hello viewers, if you are new to the channel, please hit the like and subscribe button and share it with your friends. Also, click on the bell icon so that you get the latest information about the videos that are uploaded. Hello students, welcome back to the new video. In this video, we are going to start chapter number 15, Light. In today's session, we will discuss about the introduction of the chapter and also rectilinear propagation of light. Students, today we will recall some of the facts that you have already learned about the light. You must have seen the sunlight entering in our room through a narrow hole, or you must have seen the headlight, the light from a headlight of a vehicle, or you might have seen the beam of rays coming from a torch. So what is light then? Light is something that makes the things visible to us. So we can say that light is a form of energy that makes the things visible to us in the surrounding. So we can say that light is a form of energy which enables us to interact with our surroundings in the most effective way. So here interaction means visual interaction. What does it mean? We can see the things in our surrounding. If there is no light, then we won't be able to see anything around us. Okay, so light we can define as a form of energy that enables us or that makes it possible to interact with our surrounding in what way? In a most effective way. Now, light makes the things visible to us. In simple terms, we can say that light makes the things visible to us. It does not require any medium to travel. So, light is a form of energy, but that does not require any medium to travel. Even it can travel in vacuum. What is meant by vacuum? Vacuum means empty space. There is no medium. Nothing is there. But even in such areas, the light rays can travel. Now, from where do we get light? So, the objects that give out light are called sources of light. So, sources of light means the object that give out light. So, it can be natural or artificial. That means the sources of light, the object that give out light can be naturally occurring or man-made, that is artificial. Okay, so the objects that emit their own light are called luminous objects. See, around us you can see that there are so many objects that give out light, but there are some which are not giving out the light. So such objects which give out their own light are called luminous objects. So these luminous objects can be either natural or man-made. Therefore, in the example of luminous objects, we have taken sun, other stars, candle, lamp, tube light, electric bulb, etc. So sun, stars, etc. are naturally occurring luminous objects, whereas tube light, bulb, lamp, etc. are man-made or artificial luminous objects. Next, then what are the objects that do not give out light called? So, the objects that do not emit their own light are called non-luminous objects. So, what are non-luminous objects? The objects that do not give out or do not emit their own light. Examples we can take: earth, moon, plants, the cloth, buildings, our human body, etc. So, maximum number of objects around us are non-luminous objects. The luminous objects are visible as they give out or they emit their own light. So, luminous objects are visible to us. If a tube light is working, we are able to see that because it gives out light. Then what about non-luminous objects? How do we see the non-luminous objects? For example, it is a pen. It is a non-luminous object. How do we see this pen? Because it reflects the light of the luminous objects. So what we can say? The non-luminous objects are visible because they reflect the light of the luminous objects. Now you may feel that what is mean by reflection. So how this non-luminous objects are reflecting the light. These all facts are the in detail we are going to learn in this chapter. Moving further, let us see how the materials are classified based on their ability to pass light through them. So materials are classified into three groups based on their ability to pass light through them. They are transparent, translucent and opaque. So which are the three groups of objects based on their ability to pass light? They are transparent, translucent and opaque. Then let us see one by one. Objects that allow light to pass through them completely are called transparent objects. What does it mean? A transparent object, if we take, we can see through it. For example, this glass. I can see through it because it is a transparent object. That means it allows the light to pass through them completely. Examples are glass, air, clear plastic, etc. Air we cannot see, but air is everywhere. You know that air is everywhere. Since air is a transparent object, we can see even though there is air in between us. So what we can say? Air is also a transparent object. Moving further, objects that allow light to pass through them but only partially are called translucent objects. What is meant by partially? Only a part of light that falls on the object may be allowed to pass through them and the rest are allowed to go back. Such objects are called translucent objects. So what is meant by translucent objects? The objects that allow only a part of the light falling on them to pass through them are called translucent objects. Examples we can take butter paper, frosted glass, smoke, etc. So the oily paper or butter paper which allow only a part of it, part of the light to pass through them. Similarly, frosted glass. See the glass that are used in the doors and all that. Sometimes we may be able to see that somebody is standing there, but we cannot understand clearly that who is there. Such glasses are called frosted glass. And similarly, smoke. Now, objects that do not allow light to pass through them and blocks completely are called opaque objects. So what is meant by opaque objects? The objects that do not allow light to pass through them, they block the light completely are called opaque objects. In the previous classes you have learned that when an object like a stone or a wood is shown in front of the source of light, we can get a shadow. That means shadow is formed when the opaque objects block the light. That means opaque objects do not allow the light to pass through them even a little bit. Examples are wood, stone, metals, books, etc. Most of the objects around us are opaque objects. Now, let us discuss the next topic, rectilinear propagation of light. See, when we switch on a torch in a completely dark room, we can see a beam of light that falls on the objects. Have you ever seen that beam of light? Have you ever observed that beam of light? Is it moving in a straight way or is it curved? It is seen that that beam of light always travels in a straight line. It is a straight line. Therefore, we can say that the beam of light is always straight and not curved. So, this property of light that it moves in a straight line is known as rectilinear propagation of light. So, what is the rectilinear propagation of light? The property of light that it travels in a straight line is called rectilinear propagation of light. So, this is the definition of rectilinear propagation. Now, let us discuss an activity to demonstrate the rectilinear propagation of light. So the aim of the activity is to demonstrate rectilinear propagation of light. What are the materials required for that? Three rectangular cards, a candle and a matchbox. So we need three rectangular cards which are of the same size, one candle and a matchbox. Now let us discuss the procedure of the activity. Take three cardboards A, B and C and make a pinhole on their centers. So we have taken three cardboards which are of the same size and make a small hole on their centers. Now place a burning candle on one side of the cardboard A and arrange the cardboards in such a way that the three pinholes and the candle flame are in a straight line. So we have to arrange the three cardboards in a straight line and in front of the candle, one candle is placed in front of the cardboard A. Okay. Then when we see through the cardboard C, the pinhole of the cardboard C, we can see the candle flame. So in that way we have to arrange all the three cardboards in the straight line. Now the candle flame will be visible through the pinhole of the cardboard C. So when we arrange all these three cardboards in the straight line in this way, we can see the candle flame through the pinhole of the cardboard C. Let us see the diagram. Now slightly displace any one of the cardboard and try to see the flame through the pinhole of the cardboard C. The flame will not be visible. So what is the reason there? When all the three cardboards were in the same straight line, we could see the flame through the pinhole of the cardboard C. But now we have displaced one of the cardboard. That means the light rays are not reaching to our eyes. What is the reason? Because the cardboard which is displaced blocks the light rays. Because the light rays always travel in a straight line. Now it is blocked by the displaced cardboard and hence the light rays are not reaching to our eyes and hence we are not able to see the flame. So what is the conclusion? From this activity, it is clear that light travels in a straight line. That means rectilinear propagation of light is proved. So students, I hope you have understood the topics very well. But still, if you have any doubt, you can write in the comment section. I will surely try to solve it as early as possible. Here are some review questions. Please solve it in your notebook. Thank you.